everyone, kindly settle down and please raise your hand if you have any questions in mind. By the way, we will be limiting to 2 questions, influencer, for us to accommodate everyone this evening. Thank you very much. So, this time, anyone who would like to ask Trixie Duffus? All right, where is our microphone? All right, this will have to be my microphone.
Thanks, Nick. Bye, Shaolin. See, sabi ko sa'yo, super fanboy ako. So, doon sa movie All Over You. So, thank you, guys.
Hi, congratulations for finally having your screening before a group. So, my first question is for Drag Phil, right?
Yes.
So, how did you do the... Because I believe you casted some actors from Singapore. So, how did you do the casting?
We were in co-production with Dogma Films, which is run by Sanjay Reve, a very close friend of Lino and ours. So it was through Sanjay that we were able to audition and cast for our Singaporean actors in the different nationalities that you saw in the film.
So for Kailin Direct, do you have any weird experiences in an elevator?
Yes, one time I opened the elevator and then it was just like a random day, but there was like 3 men dressed in black, head to toe from hats, and I was wondering, Halloween ba to or hindi? And then I realized, hindi naman to Halloween. So I was going down, but instead I said, no, I'm going up. So I did ride the elevator.
How about to direct light?
Well, kami actually, this experience, one of the scariest also. I shared with Dino Cayetano and Shugo Prico, my partners in Rain. We were in Hong Kong for Film Art. We rode the elevator, which didn't have a basement, and apparently there was this guy just waiting for us there. So we rode up, and we were looking at each other thinking, oh my god, is this guy a ghost or something? Then we exited our floor, the guy was following, and then we realized he was just our neighbor. It was freaky that we didn't know where he came from, so there.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. Any other one who would like to ask a question, kindly raise your hand, please. All right, to all our friends. Right here, okay.
Hi, Direct. Hi, Kylie. I'm Anna Rina TV. From watching the movie, ang impression ko, pwede din siyang gawing teleserye. Oo, sa habang nanonood ako, parang feeling ko maganda siyang i-develop into a series. Have you considered that?
We are actually considering a series for it. Good take on it. Parang may wealth of characters kasi. Like, yung mga tropa ni Jared, Jared's Army as we call them. All the actors, kasi sila Malaysian, Thai, ganyan, I asked them to build their own story. Kasi, syempre, hindi ko naman kaya i-fake yung culture nila doon. So, I asked it to come from them. So, may wealth of story nga, not just with Jared and Bettina's character, but yung mga peripheral characters in the movie. So, on point yung tanong mo. Thank you.
At saka, Derek, yung foreign cast nyo, ang galing.
Oh, thank you. Hindi, legit yun si Adrian,
diba? Yeah, wala din siya.
Especially si Byron, ang galing niya umarte.
All right, I think we can hear each other, okay. Right? So, medyo nawalan po tayo, nagkaroon tayo ng konting technical problem. But if you have any questions, kindly raise your hand. Anyone? All right. Can you speak louder? Thank you very much.
Hello, hello, hi.
Visible?
In Singapore though. Difficult.
To work in abroad?
In Singapore,
yeah. Actually, mas madali nga working in Singapore, I guess, kasi napaka-efficient nila, napaka-bilis, napaka...
No, actually, napaka-bilis, napaka-dali, napaka-efficient nila magtrabaho. we only worked with probably mga less than 30.
Lahat, yeah, half-half.
Less than 30 yung staff namin sa Singapore, and everything, the protocols, super safe, sobrang professional lahat. It didn't even feel like work when you were working, and no, actually mas na-enjoy ko nga working in Singapore, less stress, bagong environment. Tapos, napakadali and so efficient. And siguro kasi madami din kami preparation na ginawa dito. So, mas naging madali yung shoot dun sa Singapore.
So, ano, as Kylie said nga, we were about 30 or 40 people. Half were Filipinos. Tapos, sobrang blessed na nagkasundo yung both sides. Because, I mean, but you were working on one common goal eh. So, everything just went smoothly. Tapos yung sinabi ko nga before dun sa press con, yung advantage, walang traffic. So, tapos namin, wait na, kahit tayo, wait na, tulog na tayo. Parang, in that regard, parang relax siya, ganyan.
But how was it working with
them? Kylie and Pao? Sobrang okay. I mean, I think of, I'm a new director and I've been blessed to work with not just talented actors, but sobrang dedicated. So, could not have asked for any better collaborators in the project. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And now our microphone is back. Sorry for that, but now it's back. Okay. You have a question upstairs?
I'm pretty madaw with Kylie. Congratulations, Direk, and of course, Kylie Versosa for this amazing and beautiful film. Can I just say na ang ganda nung rapport yung dalawa ni Paolo bilang Bettina and Jared, no? Parang hindi bilet yung mga scenes nyo doon at nakakakilig. First things first, Miss Kylie, how does it feel working with Paolo Avellino? And after working with him, ano yung na-discover mo sa kanya?
I've always wanted to work with Paolo. Isa siya sa mga artista na gusto ko talagang maka-work kahit nag-start pa ako sa showbiz. Actually, my first movie was with him, Kasal, with Direk Ruel Bayani. And after that, hindi kami nagkatagpo bilang workmates, but this one, we were given a chance. Super bait, super professional. Papanoorin ko lang siya. May certain way siya na medyo mysterious na intriguing at the same way. He's very, very quiet. He's a very serious actor na I admire. Super madali. And work is easy with him. Parang hindi nga ako masyadong nag-uusap offset, mas onset na lang. Pero mas prefer ko na ganun kasi mas nakaka-focus kami as characters on our own. So it was really nice working with him.
Thank you, Ms. Kylie. And to Direk, correct me if I'm wrong, kayo po yung nagsulat din dito?
Yes.
Yes. Ano po yung, can you give us a little brief, paano yung conceptualization nyo while making this film elevator?
Parang isang malaking inspiration sa akin, yung lolo ko, kasi migrant din siya from China here, tapos gumawa ng bagong buhay. So parang, yun yung parang isang spirit ng sipag lang na nadala dun sa film. And then number two, yung when me and the Rain family would go to Singapore for the ATF and all that, ang dami ko nakahalubilaw mga Pilipino. And exactly yun, kung ano natin sa film, kay tropa silang lahat ng ibang nationalities. Tapos regardless, kahit, yun nga, galing kayo sa ibang lugar, you share in this common grind, this common goal to improve yourself, improve your family. So yun yung ano dun, yun yung that is malaking inspiration.
Kaya pala, sobrang relatable yung group nila doon sa work, no?
I'd like to think na kami yung nilalino pag kumakain. Uy, kamusta yung kimchi mo?
Very relatable talaga.
Thank you.
Congrats, Direk, and congrats, Kai.
First of all, congratulations, Direk. Dami mong movies.
Nandito ulit tayo.
Nakahapon na nakikita tayo. So, and congratulations po sa mga movie niyo, especially ngayon yung elevator dahil maganda nga siya, maganda yung napanood namin. So, my question na po is about, tukol sa yes, Direk, is question behind the title of elevator. I know yung setting po niya is elevator, so baka yun yung naging title. Pero ano po yung naging idea behind it? Bakit yun yung naging decision na maging title mo?
Ako talaga, yung subtext ko dyan is elevator. So, parang yun sana yun, hindi lang nila pinayagan na doing love talaga. Pero in my head, yun sana siya. Pero yun lang, kasi parang buhay, parang love. May taas, may baba. importante sumasakay ka, tumataya ka, tapos kung saan tatalin lang, diba?
Okay. May second question for you, Derek, ali, is, yung mga characters ba ni Paolo and ni Kylie, is sila na talaga yung role doon or nag-audition sila for this role?
Ah, sila. So si Kylie, parang last year pa natin, nung nagkanta tayo, we were already building this kanta. Si Paolo was always there on my Jared list. As in, parang siya nga lang talaga. Nung elevator was part of the ATF accelerator pitch. So yung parang pinapresent siya sa mga companies. Si Paolo yung nandun sa deck talaga na we were presenting the whole way through.
Thank you so much, Derek. And last, my question for is for Miss Kylie. For this role po, ano po yung naging preparations niya and paghahanda niya? And ano po yung unang naging reception niya nung binigay sa inyong role? Are you hesitant to power in one again?
No, I really, really wanted the role. Pagkita ko pa lang nung pitch, nung elevator pitch. I really wanted to do it. And then I saw the people who were behind it and everything that they did. So I really wanted to be a part of it. Preparations para dito. Ang maganda kasi kay Derek, very collaborative siya, so hindi lang yung pagsulat niya, pero nagtatanong din siya, what do you think about Bettina? Who do you think she is? So, parang onwards towards the film, parang mas nagiging Kylie na si Bettina. So, that's what I love about it. And preparations, ako bilang actor, I really need a lot of preparation. Kailangan ko ng time and space and focus to be on my own space and to have my own process. Kailangan ko talaga ng time. So, yun, I probably need like 1 to 2 months of preparation just to fit into a role.
Thank you so much po, Derek and Miss Kylie. Congratulations po ulit.
Welcome.
Okay, any other questions from our friends? Okay, right here. Itatakpo sa inyo yung microphone, don't worry.
Hi, I'm Oscar on behalf of Showbiz at Ganap. So, gusto ko na yung congratulate si Derek and Kylie sa napakagandang movie. So, yung Bida, napaka-telegenic on screen, napakaganda ni Miss Kylie, napaka-classic ng mukha niya, napaka-sophisticated. I like the styling and the setting din sa movie. So, Derek, may tanong nga ako kasi diba yung mga lines nila limited lang sa scene sa elevator. So, it just take a few minutes for the elevator to go up and down. So, yung lines pa na binibigay mo sa kanila, sa kanilang dalawa, design po ba siya na maging maiksi lang pero nakakilig at the same time?
Yes, that was a consideration. And then, by design, parang as you go, nung una diba yung kay Jari, ang bilis niya. Kasi nag-pitch talaga siya, so yung sinasabayan natin. But as they go closer sila ni Bettina, mas bumabagal ng konti. Parang hindi mo na nakapasin kasi siguro hook ka na dun sa mangyayari sa kanila. Then eventually, yung sinasabi nga ni Kylie, yung last 3 scenes nila ni Paolo na intense, after namin mag-workshop, mag-collaborate, parang i-revise ko pa yun with their inputs mga 5 more times until we really got it on point. So, yes, tama naman yung yung basa mo dun sa...
Napakaganda kasi na eksena, na-amaze ako kung paano deliver yung lines na nakakilig at short at the same time. And also to Miss Kylie, nakita ko lang sa screen na kahit sino kanino kay pair, nakita ko na kahit kanino siya i-pair kay Marco, kay Paolo, lagi siyang comfortable sa kasama niya sa eksena. So with Paolo, how do you find Paolo as a love team this movie?
I don't think Paolo and I are co-stars here. Probably not like a love team, but we're more co-stars and more co-workers. He's amazing. Tinitingnan ako siya bilang isang malaki, as in isang sorry, galing pa.
Jet lag pa si
Kylie. Jet lag pa ako, slide, guys. Pero I really admire him bilang isang aktor. And magaling. Siguro, both pareho kaming taga Baguio, so we can relate to a lot of things. We both grew up in Baguio. We both siguro are in showbiz, so we have lots of friends in common also. So hindi siya naging mahirap to become comfortable with one another. So, ayun.
So, nabanggit mo kanina si Paolo, napakatahimik sa set, very reserved. So, what is the best experience or memories na pag-usapan nyo with Paolo on the set?
Si Paolo, mahilig siya mag-joke. parang medyo bolero dead din siya, no? Oo, very cold and very, very deadpan. Yung medyo sarcastic in a way. Pero masarap din siyang sumbatan. So parang mag-joke siya, mag-joke ka din. So yung walang tawanan pero sumbatan lang kayo.
Thank you, Ms. Kylie. Congratulations again sa inyong dalawa.
Thank you very much. Up next, any other one? Kindly raise your hand if you have any questions.
Ay, hello po. Good evening po. Direk, may question ako. Matt po from La Cochera Lovers. Yeah. Ang question ko po, yung ending po ba talaga is it designed po na ganun? Para, parang open-ended siya, para pwedeng siyang lagyan ng part 2 or sequel para matuloy yung story ni Jared sa kanya.
Pwedeng, yes, pwedeng may sequel, but ako lang parang gusto ko lang mag-iwan ng hope for the audience after. So maski yung huling ano, yung huling shot natin na yung uniform na parang nagwawagayway bilang flag. So parang yun more of to inspire, uplift, ganun. So kung may part 2, hopefully, with your support, maraming manood, and then we do get a part 2 and a 3 even.
Thank you so much, Dylan.
Okay, any last question? All right, upstairs.
Hi, Derek and Ms. Kanye. My question is, if you're going to choose between love and career, and one lang, sa kanila, ano yung pipiliin nyo?
Ako?
Yeah, both of you, Derek and Ms. Kanye.
Love or career? Love. Kasi sinagot na rito dahil nung isa, ano, pwede mo makitain yung pera, pero kung may mahal ka, especially in my case, may asawa na ako, tatlong anak, so I will never replace what I have with my wife and my kids. At this point, that's the most important thing to me. And then career is a close second, but priority is love, my family.
If I were to choose between love, like a perfect love or a perfect career, I would rather choose having a perfect love, because a perfect love won't stop you from having a perfect career.
Na mind blown siya.
Actually, nasagot ko na yun, guys. So last best ko.
Okay, thank you to all our runners. Thank you very much. All right, and I think that was our last question for today. We would like to thank all of you guys for
thank
coming
you.
Over. Maraming maraming salamat. And this time, to Derek Hill and Kylie, please promote your movie, invite them, all of them. All right.
Thank you again, everyone. Hopefully, sana na acting na trigger na hila yung heartstrings niya ng movie. Sana naiyak kayo, natawa, ganyan. Hopefully you got inspired, you know, to uplift yourselves and your stations in life. So this April 24, please watch Elevator.
Sa lahat ng mga nandito, maraming salamat for coming, and lahat kayo invited dito because we know na malaki po yung influence nyo sa industriya na ito. So sana po support, sana po nagustuhan nyo po yung movie, and sana po supportahin nyo yung movie. And I hope you share it to your friends, to your vlogs, to your socials, na to help support this movie, because this support that this movie means so much to us, hindi lang para sa amin, pero it really gives a wonderful lesson about Pinoy's, about love, about hardship. So sana po tulungan niyo po kami i-promote to. So thank you so much, guys.
Thank you, everyone.